A very good morning to my lovely students. Today we are going to read about the chapter A Gift of Chappals. In this chapter, Mridu goes to Rukmani's house. Mridu is a young girl living with her grandmother and grandfather in Chennai. Mridu goes along with Tapi to her aunt. Tapi here is grandmother. She goes with Tapi to her aunt Rukmani's place one afternoon. One day she went to Rukmani's place. There she meets her cousins, Lali, Ravi and Meena. Everyone at Rukmani's house was glad to see Mridu. There was a thick bitter berry bush in their backyard. Ravi took her beside that. There was a small little kitten inside a torn football. The small creature was busy drinking milk that was kept inside a half shell of a coconut. Now Meena informed Mridu that they have found the kitten outside their house in the morning of that day. But they must keep it as a secret only, otherwise the grandmother will leave their house immediately. Ravi was upset that they were being taught to be kind towards animals, but when he was trying to do so, the elders were screaming at them, calling the kitten a dirty creature. His grandmother was suspicious while he was taking out milk for the kitten from kitchen. He had to drink more than half of the milk to make her believe that it was for him. He also told Mridu that they have named the kitten as Mahindran. Now the name of the kitten is Mahindran. Mridu loved the name because it sounded real like, unlike those cute ones you keep for the kittens. Ravi further added that its complete name was Mahindravarm Pallav Punnai and MP Punnai in short. Now just see, the name of the kitten is MP Punnai. He informed her he could make it from its fur that it was a fine breed cat, a close relative of lion family like the one that Palwa kings used in their emblem. To this, Mridu giggled, which instigated Ravi to prove his knowledge about the history further. On his school trip to Mahabalipuram, he had seen statue of a lion and he firmly believed that it was the ancestor of that kitten. He proudly announced that his small kitten is the descendant of Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. He reminded Mridu of cats being worshipped in ancient Egypt. He believed it to be the descendant of cat goddess. Now there was some noise. Ravi was busy in making all proud announcements about his kitten when a weird sound screech came from the window. Mridu was shocked while Mahindran was frightened, scared. Mahindran jumped with fear on a dry or red chilies kept under the sun for drying. With the screeching noise counting on the background, Mridu inquired what it was. Ravi informed her that it was Lali learning to play the violin. Now the cousin, one of the cousin was learning violin. Mridu peeped from the window, looked from the window, and she found Lali was holding the violin in an awkward position, sitting a bit away from her music teacher, who had his back towards the window. The teacher was Balit, with a fringe of oiled black hair falling around his ears. There was gold chain in the neck and a ring on his hand. He had a big toe with which he was thumping the ground. He was playing the notes perfectly on the violin while Lali was struggling hard. His tracks were filled with melody while Lali continued missing the note. Now there was one beggar. Children were having fun peeping from the window when Rukmani called Ravi to send the beggar away. She was fed up with the beggar coming to the place for a week now and wanted him to find another place. The beggar had made himself comfortable at the garden. He was leaning against the neem tree with his upper clothes spread under it. He was about to snooze when he heard Ravi asking him to leave. He was shocked hearing this and called for the lady of the house. An irritated Rukmani told Ravi that there wasn't anything left in the kitchen and asked the beggar not to come again. Her voice was so loud that Ravi didn't have to repeat her words to the beggar. The beggar told them that he would leave after taking rest for a while. It was too hot outside and there were blisters in his feet. The children were in pain saying this and started making plans to give him chappals. Now here comes what will, whose chappal? What about the chappals? Now Mridu remembered seeing a pair of old grey chappals while she had entered Ravi's house. Now Mridu had seen one pair of chappals when she entered the house. She asked Ravi whom they belonged to. Ravi took the chappals and gave it to the beggar and asked him not to come again. Now just see, Ravi just gave the chappals. Whose chappal was that? The beggar went away wearing the chappals and blessing the children. It was the time for the music teacher to leave. He was looking for his chappals. Now whose chappal was that? Music teacher. He called Lali and looked everywhere, but didn't find them. Lali informed Rukmani about it. Rukmani questioned the children if they had seen anyone picking up the chappals. Rukmani was really angry and Mridu couldn't control anymore. She told her that they had given the music teacher's chappal to the beggar. Rukmani went inside and brought Gopu Mama's new chappal and gave them to the music teacher. The teacher was happily getting the new chappals, but still pretended as though it was tough for him to accept them. Rukmani, the loving mother, the teacher called Ravi a monkey, an incarnation of the Lord Hanuman, which seemed clear that Rukmani didn't like. She wanted the teacher to leave immediately. Now, what happened at last? After he left, she called the children home and offered them some snacks. She thanked God that go to the office in chappals, but needed them after coming home immediately. She wondered what she will tell him, giving a hint that she will take the blame on herself. Now just see how naughty the children were.